Welcome back. In today's video, we will start working on post-CRUD operations, which is a more interesting part of this Laravel 11 blog project tutorial series. Create a new controller for managing posts. As you can see, the post controller was created successfully. Open the web.php route file and add new routes for posts. Add a get route for displaying the add post page. Add a post route for creating a new post. Also, add a get route for all posts page. After that, run the PHP artisan optimize command. Next, add this method inside the PostController class. Let's start by generating the list of categories that we will use in the add post form. Create this view. As you can see, we have add post page. Let's design this page. Add a form that will help us create posts. This text must match this. This text must match this. This text must match this. As you can see, the post categories are displayed correctly. This text must match this. Great, our form is ready to use. Next, we need to preview the selected image for the post's featured image. As you can see, after selecting an image file, we can preview it below the file input. However, when you select an image with an unsupported aspect ratio, you will see this error. Also, when you select a non-image file type, you will see this error. So, make sure to select an image file. Next, enter tags separated by commas in this input field. To improve presentation, we need to initialize the Bootstrap Tags input plugin on this input field. This admin template includes the plugin. So, we need to include the CSS and JS files of this plugin in the add_post.blade.php file. To activate the plugin on this input field, add the data role attribute here. As you can see, we can now add and remove post tags as needed. Next, we need to create a posts table. Go to the terminal and create a new post model with a migration file. As you can see, the post model was created successfully. Open the generated posts migration file and add the necessary columns for the posts table. Next, open the post model and add the feeable array. Since we have a slug column in the posts table, we need to include the sluggable package in the post model. The source will be the post title. Then, run the PHP artisan migrate command. As you can see, the posts table has been added to the database. We will submit this form using Ajax. Next, add the createPost method inside the PostController class. First, validate the form. The post title must be required and unique in the posts table. The post content must be required. The post category must be required and must exist in the categories table. The post's featured image must be required, an image file, and not exceed 1 megabyte in size. Let's check if the validation works. As you can see, the validation works perfectly. When you select an image larger than 1 megabyte, you will see this error. But when you choose an image under 1 megabyte, no error occurs. Let's continue. When a form submission includes a featured image, we need to upload the image first. If the featured image upload fails, return an error message. If the featured image is uploaded successfully, store the post details in the database. When the post is successfully inserted into the database, return a success message. Otherwise, return an error message if the post is not inserted. Let's test it. Initially, we don't have any records in the posts table. Let's create our first post. Great, as you can see, after submitting the form, we receive a success message. Checking the database, we see the newly inserted post. Additionally, the post's featured image was uploaded to the public posts images folder. Let's create another post. Friends, I hope you learned how to create a post. See you in the next video.